Hi, this is COMP1010 at the University of Manitoba. I'm Dr. Celine LaTulip, and in this video I'll talk to you about using impossible value partially filled arrays. So in some of the earlier videos, we saw that using partially filled arrays often means that if we want to insert an item or delete an item, we have to shift items up or down, either to make space to insert or to move over and fill up a previously filled slot. And this can be kind of inefficient, and it just seems like a lot of work. What if we just want to actually leave some empty bins in the middle of the array and then come back and fill them in later if we add new items? That would work as long as we really don't care about keeping the data items in order. And what we do then is we use impossible values, some value that just doesn't make sense for our data, and put that in the empty bins as we go. So in these two examples, we have an array of ages, and we're marking empty bins by putting in an impossible value, which is -1. And that makes sense because you can't have a person whose age is -1. So this is an actual age, this is actually an empty slot, this is an actual age, that's an actual age, and this is an empty slot. Similarly, this one for car speed also is using -1 because speed can't actually be negative. So this negative value denotes that this slot is empty and we could store a different car speed in here. So when we want to use impossible value partially full arrays, what we do is we declare a constant that actually defines what that impossible value is. So something like final int empty equals -1. And then if we want to clear or set all the slots in an impossible value array to be open or empty, we use a loop and we go through and we just set every bin to this constant that we declared. So here we're looping through from 0 up to the length of the array and we're setting each slot to empty. So each slot would contain -1. So this is a little bit different from what we've done before with our partially filled arrays, where we kept a counter for where the next empty slot was. In that technique, if we wanted to set the whole array to be empty, we would just set the size to 0. So that was faster. We didn't have to iterate through and set each value. So there's pros and cons to using this version, the impossible value version of partially full arrays. Now, if we want to insert data in an impossible value partially filled array, what we're going to do is we're going to go through our array and find the first empty bin. And what we're trying to do is get the index of that bin. So here we have int index equals next empty of my array. So next empty is a function. We're passing the array in and it's going to give us back an index. So here's that function. First, we're setting an int value, an int variable next to be not found. So again, this is our impossible value. And we're going to iterate through the array from 0 up to the length of the array as long as next still is -1 or not found. And then we're going to look at each slot. If that slot is empty or -1, then we're going to actually set our variable next to be the index of that slot. And we won't keep on looping because now next won't be -1, it'll be an actual array index. So we'll sort of end this for loop and then we'll return that index value. If we get through this for loop and we never find an empty slot, then we're just going to return not found, which is -1. So we'll know that there isn't an empty slot. And once we're done coming back from this, we can then use the index we got and actually put new data into that bin. So if we want to search an impossible value PFA, it's going to look fairly similar. We're going to try to, in this case, find the index of a given item of our key. And so again, we're going to have our impossible value defined up here as a constant. It's not found and it's set to -1. And then we have a function that's called find. We pass in the array and we pass in what we're looking for, which is our key. So again, we're going to set an index and use our impossible value and initially say that we haven't found an index where this key is. We're going to loop through our array from 0 up to the length of the array. And we're going to keep on doing this while our index is equal to not found. And if for any slot in the array, the contents of that slot is equal to key, what we're searching for, then we set our index to I, which is our loop counter. And that means we'll stop iterating through this for loop because index will no longer be not found. It will be actually a number, a positive integer value. And then we'll return that index. So again, if we never found our key, index would still just be not found and we would be returning -1. But if we found the key, we'd be returning the index into the array. So this is a linear search. And in this case, we can't do the more efficient binary search because this array we're not keeping sorted. We're just throwing stuff into any empty slot wherever we find one. If we want to delete from an impossible value partially filled array, then we again need to find the index of the item to be deleted. So we're going to use our find function that we just had on the last slide, pass in the key. We're going to get that index. And then if the key was found, so if the index is valid, we're just going to delete the data in that bin by setting the slot at that index in our array to our impossible value to empty. And we have to, but we only do this if index is not found, because if index is not found, index would be -1 and we wouldn't want to put -1 in here. That would cause our program to crash. So the nice thing about impossible value partially filled arrays is deleting a slot or setting it to empty is just a simple, you know, one operation. We just set it to empty. We don't need to then shift items down to sort of fill up that space. So let's think about sort of comparing count as you go versus impossible value for these two different versions of a partially filled array. The impossible value is kind of more flexible. You can insert or delete anywhere where there's an empty slot. Well, you can insert where there's an empty slot and you can delete anywhere by just setting that slot to empty. The trick with impossible values is sometimes it's actually hard to decide on a good impossible value. So for age and speed, obviously we're only going to have positive integers. Using -1 makes sense. But what if your array isn't just positive integers? It may be more difficult to find something that's a suitable impossible value. The count as you go version, where we keep a pointer to the size, which sort of points at the next empty slot in the array, can be more efficient. It's faster to insert an item. It's faster to erase all data. But if you need to insert or remove items often, then it starts to lose its efficiency because you have to do a lot of shifting of other items. But the count as you go version of partially filled array is the technique that you'll see most often used in computing. So one last thing is, when you have partially filled arrays and you're just slowly adding more data to it and adding more data, you could get to a point where your partially filled array is actually not partially filled, it's full, and we still want to add more data. And so then what we have to do is detect that condition and call a helper function to make our partially filled array a lot bigger. And what this actually means is creating a whole new array and copying all the values over. So what we're going to do in this case, we're going to create a helper function that enlarges the array. We're going to pass the array that needs to be enlarged to that helper function, and it's going to return a new array object that's going to be double the size of the array. It's also going to do the work of copying the data over from our original array to the new array, and then set all those extra bins at the end to empty. So at the end, it will return the address of the new array, and so we'll be pointing at the new array, and the old array will get garbage collected. So let's look at what this looks like. Here's the code. So we have enlarge array. We pass in our original array. And then inside this array, inside this function, we create a new array. It's also an int. And the size of our new array is the original length times 2. So this is where we're creating an array that's double the size. Then we go through and we copy the existing data. So we go from 0 up to original length, and we copy from the data from the slots and original into the slots and new array. And then if it's a partially filled array, we have to mark those extra bins as empty. So from I equals the original length up to the new array length, which is sort of that second half of this new double size array, we're going to set those slots to empty. And then we simply return new array. And so you're going to call this and set it to the array pointer that you already have, and you'll suddenly have a new double-sized array. Okay, so that's it for partially filled arrays and using impossible values. And thanks for watching.